for 99% of all smart contract use cases we see today, you can do exactly what you do with EVM, but then with hooks. And I think hooks are more efficient in many ways. But there are a couple of limitations, obviously, because we prioritize forward progress, transaction speed, low fees and everything over complete freedom when you're developing something. So the hooks are heavily built in advance based on the computation, the worst case execution, basically, of a hook. So there's an incentive to write efficient hooks. And then storing data on Ledger is also relatively expensive in hooks. So you can work with all the data at your disposal on Ledger, but if you want to commit your custom data to the Ledger, it's going to be quite expensive. For example, if you want to keep track of accounts, you want to make a list of accounts, you can do that in your hook, you can store that, but it's quite expensive. But for enterprise solutions or for key recovery solutions, it makes perfect sense to allocate some funds for the add-on features you get. And hooks can execute only at the start of a transaction or at the end of a transaction. So it's either when a transaction is initialized, that's when you can programmatically still say, I don't want this transaction, for example, and it's not going to enter your account or it's not going to leave your account. Very important feature. The other stage is after the transaction. If the transaction went through consensus, if the transaction is okay, you may want to execute add-on logic to do something based on what happened in this transaction. Really simple example. You got a deposit of 1000 XRP and you want to route it partially to your savings account, small part to a carbon offset account, and you want to keep the rest in your account but turn it into a stablecoin, for example. Retail use case. So you can do that after the transaction happened. And we have gone through a lot of different use cases we're going after ourselves, use cases where we see other developers going after, and we think hooks can cater all of them. Of course, we don't know what we don't know, so people are going to come up with things, and we're going to have this creative process again where we might have to revisit some things. But the one thing where I think hooks are maybe not the go-to environment, smart contract execution sandbox, is the typical DeFi stuff that's happening. If you look at, for example, decentralized exchange, token issuing, AMMs, stuff like that, it's quite inefficient to use hooks. Now, on EVM networks, the only way to implement it is through smart contracts. On the XRPL, I think those clear use cases, they just should be implemented natively. Don't write smart contracts for them. Unless if you want to pilot something and basically build the spec of what's going to be implemented natively later.